What's up guys, welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. In today's video we're going to be talking about scene transitions for your live stream. So when you go from a scene like your game scene back to your intermission scene, actually having a transition between those two scenes and why you'd want to do that. Scene transitions might seem like an unnecessary and maybe an unnoticeable aspect of your stream, but if you pay a little bit more attention to some of the top streamers on Twitch, you'll notice that most of them are using some sort of stinger to seamlessly transition between game and intermission scenes. Not only do these subtle transitions add to your production value, but they can also help reinforce your branding and make for a more engaging stream for your viewers. In this video, we're going to be talking about how you can set up OBS to use these scene transitions to up the production level of your live stream. After a quick message from our sponsor. Nerd or Die has just released the Arcade Pop Stream Package, a clean design with a retro feel that includes three different color options and is compatible with both Streamlabs and Stream Elements. Use the link in the description to get yourself an extra 10% off at checkout. There are quite a few different options for scene transitions in OBS Studio. Fade, cut, swipe, slide, a custom stinger which we'll talk more about later, fade to color, and Luma wipe. To find and to set up these scene transitions, you need to open up OBS and come down to the scene transitions section. And you should see here a couple of options already in the drop down by default, fade and cut. But as I mentioned, there's a few others that you can add. You add those by using this plus icon. You can remove any of the scene transitions by using the minus icon. And there's also a settings cog, which will bring up the properties of the selected scene transition. And also for fade and for some of the other transitions, you have the option to set a duration for how long the transition will take. If you add the Luma wipe transition and open up the properties, you'll actually see that there's over 30 different transition options to choose from. And although some of them remind me of those transitions you used to get in old editing programs like Windows Movie Maker, others actually work really well and look pretty awesome. So I definitely recommend going through this long list and seeing if anything appeals to you. You don't need to close down the properties window to test each transition. Simply swap scenes in the background to see how it looks and then move on to the next Luma wipe in the list and test that. Write down the names of any of the ones that you like. It really doesn't take long to get through the list of 30 or so that are included. You'll also get the option to invert the transition if you want to, as well as a way to change the softness of the edges of the transition image shape. Before we get into stinger transitions, which I know a lot of you are interested in, it's worth mentioning that a couple of updates ago, OBS added the ability to set default scene transitions for specific scenes. This is particularly useful if you want to use simple cuts when you're changing camera angles, or maybe you're using one of those three-step zooms that a lot of people use, but you want a more advanced stinger transition when you're going between, say, your game and your intermission scenes. To set a default transition, all you need to do is simply right-click the scene you want to set the transition to, go down to Select Transition Override, and then pick the transition you want to use from the list. Now, I imagine most of you are interested in the stinger transition, because this allows you to add a completely custom video with transparency to be played as the transition between two different scenes. OBS will play this video overlaid on top of your current scene and then swap to a new scene at a specific frame or specific time in the video to make sure that things appear seamless. It's worth noting though that this does add some complexity to your OBS setup, and so this will definitely have a higher impact on your PC than if you were just using a simple transition like a fade, a slide or a Luma wipe. Now specifically how a stinger transition works is that the video file will have some transparent sections to it at the start and at the end, which is where you'll see your current and your next scenes through. At some point near the middle of the stinger transition, the video should take up and fill the whole frame with no transparency, and this is where you can set the actual scene transition in OBS to take place in the background. To actually create your own stinger is a relatively complex process that really requires some more advanced video editing software like Adobe After Effects. I'm well aware that I haven't covered any After Effects on this channel before, but if there is a demand from the gaming careers community to learn how to specifically do that and create your own stingers, do let me know down in the comments and I'll be sure to create a video that's specifically about how to create your own custom stinger in After Effects. But the good news is that there are many different free and cheap stingers available to download from the internet that you can have and add to your live stream today. So to demonstrate actually how you set up OBS to use a custom stinger, I'll be using the new Arcade Pop Stinger from Nerd or Die, which you can also download for free. You just need to select free extras from the dropdown, and that includes the stingers. So once those have finished downloading, you need to head over to OBS and look for the scene transition settings, and you want to be clicking the plus icon to add a new stinger transition. Name this whatever you want, and a reminder that you can add more than one stinger, so it's worth naming it properly, something that's going to make you realize which stinger you are editing. Next, you'll want to actually browse to the video file, the actual WebM stinger file that you have downloaded. So find where you downloaded the stingers and extracted them to a certain folder, and make sure that you're adding the video file that you want to, whether it's purple, light, or dark. Next, you have this option for transition point type, and the options here are time in milliseconds or frame. And this is the actual point in the video where the video fills the whole frame and there is no transparency. So this is the point that you're telling OBS to actually switch the scene in the background. So if you know the exact time that happens in milliseconds or the exact frame that happens in the video, you just want to select which one of those it is. For these, if you are following along and have downloaded these Arcade Pop scene transitions stingers, then you want to set time, and the time is 500 milliseconds is where the actual transition happens. Finally, audio monitoring. This is just whether or not you as the broadcaster want to hear the audio of the transition. So some of these stingers come with audio, and if you want to be able to hear that yourself as well as your stream hearing it, then you can set this to monitor and output. If you don't want to hear it yourself because you're going to be changing scenes so often, then you of course can choose monitor off, so it only gets sent out to your stream. And then finally, you have audio fade style. This is how you want the audio to fade from scene to scene. So say you're playing a game in your game scene and you have an intermission scene with some background music. How do you want the audio to fade between the two scenes as you transition? So you can choose to either fade out and fade in of the new scene, or you can choose to crossfade so it has a little bit more of a mix, and it's completely up to you. So once you are happy, you can click OK to close down the properties and then test out the scene transition by swapping scenes within OBS. And hopefully you should see that the transition happens as the stinger has covered the whole of the screen. It should look really seamless. Of course, if you are using the audio as well in the stinger transitions, make sure that you've got the level right in your audio mixer in OBS, just to make sure that it's balanced with the rest of the audio and your microphone and things like that. But that is how you do scene transitions in OBS. So hopefully now you are using some scene transitions in OBS and just adding that little bit of professionalism to your live streams, because I was surprised at how many people weren't doing this when I've been reviewing streams as part of the Discord and part of the Patreon perks. Speaking of Patreon, I would like to give a massive shout out to this month's patrons. These people here help to run this channel by pledging small amounts of money every month, and they allow me to do this as a full-time job and keep creating tutorials for you guys. So massive thanks to my patrons, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.